I will be analyzing this painting by Eugene Delacroix by focusing on every specific element that he includes and interpreting it through my research.
Eugene Delacroix, or as in French, Eugene Delacroix, was a famous artist who was born on April 26, 1798. He was a famous artist known for expressing his romance through his artwork. Eugene has many artworks that were also a symbol of romanticism. His painting, Liberty Leading the People, was created in the year of 1830. During this period of time, the French Revolution was happening. This revolution can also be known as the July Revolution. This painting portrays an experience of what happened on July 28th of 1830. During the revolution, there was conflicts between liberals and revolutionaries against the French monarchy.
Charles X was a king in France during the July Revolution, where freedom was limited of the press. On the three glorious days, police were running down streets, attempting to get rid of any revolutionary newspapers. As Charles X abdicates his power, Louis-Philippe gains power of the throne.
Near the end of the revolution, Louis-Philippe can no longer serve as a king because of an economic crisis.
As you can see, this is a cat. And cats are soft and fluffy. And they meow. Okay, enough with the cat. The woman is the focal point in the painting. Her dress seems to be slipping down her chest, while her breasts are being exposed. We see the woman holding the flag of France, but also holding a weapon in her left hand. We only see her left foot when no shoe is being worn.
To the bottom left corner, a man is on the ground with no bottoms on, with his eyes closed. You can also see the way there is a young boy kneeling down to the woman, who appears to be wearing a bichrome, and what looks to be some sort of a bandana on his head.
Near the middle right side, we can see some portion of buildings. The smoke seems to be covering almost the entire sky. There are two men that are on the left side of the woman. One has a tall black hat holding a gun with two hands. The other has a smaller hat with a sword in his right hand.
There is a boy to the right of the woman, who appears to be of a much younger age than the rest of the other boys. He is holding a gun in each of his hands, and also has a bag that he is carrying across his chest.
Eugene Delacroix used organic lines for most of his painting. He uses geometric lines in the weapons and also in the buildings that can barely be seen behind all of the smoke.
Delacroix uses value to make the audience focus on the focal point, which is the woman in the center. The painting consists of neutral colors. He uses a lot of shades of blue, from the sky to the clothes that the people are wearing. What colors are the ones being more used? Eugene created the artwork in the year of 1830. The intended viewer would be the French people.
Oil on canvas is what the artist used in order to create this masterpiece.
Liberty Leading the People was created in the year of 1830 after the July Revolution. This artwork was created in France. The purpose for creating this artwork was to show an experience of Eugene Delacroix while also showing an expression of romanticism through the use of art. Iconography is the visual images and symbols used in a work of art, or the study of interpretation of these. Delacroix decides to include a focal point in the picture, which is a lady whose breasts are being exposed. He decides to use the woman as a symbol to represent the liberty that is guiding the people. While trying to analyze this artwork, many questions came across my mind. According to Adriana Polyanko, it is stated that Delacroix used this woman to elevate the woman as being a symbol of a working woman into liberty incarnate. In this source, it also mentions how in the time of year, Eugene Delacroix saw the year of 1830 as a period of time of irresolution and tightness about the future of liberty when it came to post-revolutionary relations. According to the information, it is believed that the painting created expressed realistic and symbolic ways in which the three glorious days brought victory to the people that embodied power for Louis Philippe.
In a book by Isabella Alston, she mentions how the painting illustrates the action of the people searching for liberty, fraternity, and equality. Even though many soldiers appear to be dead on the ground, the dark tone is being overpowered by the focal point, which is the feminine spirit of liberty. Through the years of 1822 and 1831, it is stated by Roy Howard how Eugene developed the understanding of heroism and used that understanding to make it part of his paintings.
The boy who is standing to the right of the woman has been noticed as an inspiration of the Gavroche character who plays a role in Victor Hugo's 1862 novel called Les Misérables.
This young boy is known to be homeless and also a child who lives in the streets of Paris. If it wasn't for all of the weapons, I would have assumed that the men were just in a war between each other trying to win over the woman.
Kind of like this.
But then again, that's not what Eugene wanted. From reading the title, I knew that the people were being led by liberty. But I assumed it was the flag that the people were looking up to.
The woman was my next assumption, but it seems strange to me that the woman was a symbol. It turns out that the woman is actually a symbol as the French Republic named Marianne. Marianne is a national symbol for France, a representation of liberty and reason. The same way the United States has a goddess of liberty, which is the Statue of Liberty, France has Marianne.
This is my artwork. Since Eugene includes the France flag, I decided to include the Chicago flag. The France flag represents the ideals of the French Revolution, which are liberty, fraternity, and equality. The Chicago flag has four stars that each represent four different events that occurred. The four Dearborn, the Chicago Fire, the Columbian Exposition, and the Century of Progress. Both flags represent major events that shaped the way we all live now in today's century.